is searching for her origins the way I think we all do, even if we are not orphans as she is. We are always looking for identity. We are always trying to understand who we are and who our real family is, both those we are born to and those we are meant to be with. I always start a book with place. I always pick a place I know well. The Elizabeth Islands are right off of Cape Cod where I live, and so I've spent years and years with the ocean. I have salt water in my veins, I think, and I love the ocean. So I wanted to set a book in a place I love, which is on the sea. And these islands do exist. I made up one of them, but most of them do exist. And they're very beautiful, and they're very much the same as they were decades ago. I discovered a lot about these islands as I was doing research to find out what it was like to live there in the 1920s. And I learned a lot about the leper colony and a lot about how people lived on these islands. And so I incorporated those facts into the book, but I never like to do too much research because then it feels like something I don't know well. So I put in the details I have to put in order to make it authentic. I try not to think about the age of my reader because I think children are much smarter than we give them credit for. So I just write the story without thinking too much about who is going to be reading it. I try to make sure it's a good story with good characters and plenty of things for any reader to learn. I would like to do a lot of things more slowly than I do. I have a full-time job, and I write, and I'm an artist, and I have a lot of friends, and I have family. So I'm constantly running from one thing to the next, and I feel like I'm always out of breath. I always long for stillness and quiet. So in 2020, I plan to cut back on what I do so that I can do it better and more slowly.